Τώρα, ευθείες βολές κατά της τακτικής που ακολούθησε η Κριστίν Λαγκάρτ και οι Ευρωπαίοι εναντί της Ελλάδας, εξαπολύει με συνέντευξή του στον Αλφα και τον Θάνο Δημάδη, ο Βραζιλιάνος εκπρόσωπος στο Διεθνές Νομισματικό Ταμείο. Ο εκπρόσωπος της Βραζιλίας στο Ταμείο, λοιπόν, καταγγέλλει ότι δόθηκαν μεγάλα δάνεια στην Ελλάδα, όχι για να σωθεί η χώρα μας, αλλά οι γερμανικές και οι γαλλικές τράπεζες. Παράλληλα, κατηγορεί την Τρόικα ότι μετέφερε μια λανθασμένη εικόνα στην διοίκηση του Ταμείου για το ελληνικό πρόγραμμα.
The Greek programs were not among the best chapters in IMF history. I was critical of the way the Greek issue was being handled by the Troika, and including the IMF. One of the major problems of the programs that were proposed was that they put too much of a burden on Greece and not enough of a burden on Greece's creditors. So, for example, the first program in 2010 was presented as a bailout of Greece. But in reality, it was more a bailout of the private creditors of Greece. Greece received enormous amounts of money, but this money was used basically to allow the exit of, for example, French banks, German banks, that were paid at par without any contribution to the restructuring of the Greek economy. And I thought the programs that were proposed for Greece and approved for Greece were much too one-sided. They relied too much on sacrifices on the part of Greece and not enough on sacrifices on the part of Greece's creditors. And I think this needs to be changed going forward. In my opinion, the debt is way too large, and a solution to the Greek crisis should include a restructuring of the Greek debt, with its European official creditors. This view is perhaps not widely shared, not a consensus view, but I think if you look at the situation in Greece, it's difficult to see how Greece will extricate itself from this serious economic and social crisis without some debt restructuring. When I refer to debt restructuring, I'm thinking mainly of the largest part of the debt of Greece now, which is the large debt accumulated vis-à-vis its European partners. If I can give an opinion, I think the Greek government should respect the IMF's preferred creditor status. Any restructuring of debt should affect other creditors that do not have this preferred creditor status. Not recommend that Greece attempt to restructure its debt with the IMF. I think it's important that the new Greek authorities continue their dialogue with the staff, with the technical people of the fund, but that they also reach out to the political authorities here in the fund, that they speak to the executive directors, that they, when they come to Washington, they present their views directly to the executive directors. It's important also to establish a dialogue and perhaps to invite some executive directors of the fund to visit Greece. The Troika, or the institutions as they are now called, should respect the sovereignty of the Greek nation. The IMF, the European partners, cannot behave as though the elections did not happen. In my opinion, it would be wrong for the IMF to indicate that it understands that Greece should stick to all commitments made by the previous government, in the previous program. That's not to be expected. But it would be a mistake, in my opinion, to insist that the new Greek government be held to all the commitments, or to most of the commitments made by the previous governments. This has to be reviewed. The IMF should consider the fact that the targets for the fiscal adjustment, the targets for the primary surplus of the Greek public sector, need to be revised downwards and substantially. Yes, I believe the fund should show flexibility. I believe the fund intends to show flexibility. The fund normally is flexible.